Hello children, welcome to Deeksha Online Classes. Today I am going to explain some important MCQs for CET from Organic Chemistry. Which of the following is correct? So to get the correct answer, you write the detailed structure of each option. Option A, around this carbon there are 4 CH3 groups. Opposite to that, the name given is neopentane. 5 carbons are there and 1 neocarbon is there. That's why its name is neopentane. A is correct option. Then you check the option B. Numbering from right to left, 1, 2, 3, 4. Bute. At second position, ene is there, so bute-2-ene. At first carbon, ol is there, so bute-2-ene-1-ol is the correct option. When A and B both are there, both are correct, and fourth option is all, then no need to check the third option. So directly you can take the correct option D. Next one, CnH2nO2. Is the general formula for which open chain compound? CnH2nO2 is the general formula to represent two types of open chain compounds, carboxylic acids and esters. So here given is C. IUPAC name of the compound given. The functional group is CHO. CHO is chain terminating functional group. So, C of CHO always gets number 1. Numbering 1, 2, 3. Root word is prop. At second position, ene is there. Prop, 2-ene. And the secondary suffix is all. Prop, 2-ene, all. So, A is correct answer. Next, also based on IUPAC name, double bond. So this is alkene basically. Carbons having double bond should get the lowest possible number. So numbering is started from this carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there is one substituent, methyl, on third position. So 3-methyl. Cyclohexene, no need to mention 1-ene. So carbon with a double bond only gets number 1 in this case. That's why no need to mention hex 1-ene. The correct option is A. Next one. Which of the following represents a homologous series? Series of compounds with same general formula, same chemical properties, and any two consecutive compounds are separated by a formula CH2 is called homologous series. So all alkanes are one series, alkenes one series, like that alcohols belonging to one series, one class of compounds. So in each option, 3 compounds are given. You check the first option. Ethane is alkane, ethylene is alkene. That's why these three are not belonging to same series. Wrong option. Option B, methane is alkane, ethane is alkane, but third one is propanone, is a ketone. So these three are not belonging to same homologous series. Wrong option. Next, C option, ethanol, alcohol, propanoic acid, carboxylic acid. So these are not belonging to same. Now, no need to check the fourth option. Fourth option will be the correct answer, even though better to check once. Butane is alkane. 2-methylbutane, alkane. 2,3-dimethylbutane. These are all alkane. These are all belonging to alkane homologous series. So, correct option is D. Next, the compound which has one isopropyl group. So we should know what is isopropyl group. This is called isopropyl group. So in first you write the structure for each one, then you can find out which one is having such type of isopropyl group. So last but one carbon should have one CH3 branch. First option A, pentane. Let us take 5 carbons. Second carbon has 2 methyl groups. Third carbon also has 2 methyl groups. So there is no isopropyl group. This is wrong option. Next, 2,2 dimethyl pentane. At second position, there are 2 methyl groups. So at second position, if one methyl group is there, that is isopropyl. If 2 methyl groups are there at second position, that is neo. So second option is wrong. 2,2,3 trimethyl pentane. At second position, there are 2 methyl groups. That's why there is no isopropyl group. So option D is correct, since 3 are wrong. Okay, even though correct answer we got, better to check that one also. Pentane, 2 methyl pentane. At second position, CH3. So you complete the structure. In this 2 methyl pentane, isopropyl group is present. That's why correct answer is D. Urea was made in the laboratory by Frederick Wohler from. According to Berzelius, organic compounds are prepared, generated by only living organisms due to presence of vital force. But for the first time, Frederick Wohler proved that organic compounds also synthesized in the laboratory from non-living things. First time, he prepared well-known organic compound from a non-living salt, non-living thing, that is ammonium cyanate, NH4CNO. This is a salt, NH4 plus CNO minus. On heating, ammonium cyanate rearranged to give urea, NH2CONH2. This is urea. So the correct option is ammonium cyanate, NH4 plus CNO minus. So answer is C. Which of the following has a bond formed by overlapping of sp3 sp hybrid orbitals? So the sigma bond between two carbons, definitely with hybrid orbitals only. Any sigma bond between two carbons due to overlapping of hybrid orbitals only. So which sigma bond, CC sigma bond, is formed by the overlapping of sp3 and sp hybrid orbitals, you have to find out. So for that purpose, from each option you find out the type of hybridization at each carbon. Triply bonded carbon is sp carbon. Next carbon also triply bonded sp. CH3 carbon is sp3 carbon, since no pi bond. So if you observe second carbon and third carbon, between these two sigma bond is formed. The sigma bond between two carbons compulsory due to overlapping of hybrid orbitals only. So sp hybrid orbital of second carbon overlaps with sp3 hybrid orbital of third carbon. That's why the sigma bond formed is nothing but sp3 sp sigma bond. So A is correct option. In the option B, sp3, this is sp2 sp2 sp3, there is no sp hybrid orbital also, so B is wrong. Next option C, sp2 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 sp2, all hybrid orbitals are sp2, so this is wrong. sp and sp, this is also wrong. That's why our correct option is A. Which of the following compounds contain only secondary carbon atoms? carbon atom which is just attached to two other carbons is called secondary carbon. So middle carbon is secondary carbon in this case. Cyclohexane, 6 carbons are attached with one another in the form of ring. This is cyclohexane. At each carbon, 2 hydrogens. So if you check in this compound, each carbon is connected to 2 other carbons. That's why every carbon is 2 degree carbon. So correct answer is cyclohexane. Only secondary carbons should be there. Other carbons should not be there. If you take option B, methyl cyclopentane. Here, carbon of CH3 is 1 degree carbon. Carbon of cyclohexane holding CH3 is 3 degree carbon. Of course, other carbons may be 2 degree. But this is wrong answer, since 3 degree carbon also there. Same thing, 2 methyl pentane. And even in pentane, 2 types of carbons are there. 1 degree carbon is there, 2 degree carbon is there. So, D option is wrong. 2 methyl pentane. Here this is 2 methyl pentane. So 1 degree carbon is there, 3 degree carbon also there. That's why this is wrong option. Correct answer is A. Next one. An aromatic molecule will have. According to Occle's rule, to become aromatic compound, it has to fulfill 4 conditions. First one, it should be cyclic. Second one, all atoms in that molecule should be on the same plane, planar. Third one, complete conjugation. Throughout the ring, conjugation should be there. Complete conjugation, cyclic conjugation. And fourth one, very, very important, it should have 4n plus 2 pi electrons, delocalized electrons, maybe 2, maybe 6, maybe 10, and so on. So now select the correct one. First one, it should have 4n pi electrons. This is wrong. Second one, it should have 4n plus 2 pi electrons. So aromatic compound should have 4n plus 2. So second one is correct. Third one, it should be planar. Third one is also correct. It should be cyclic, fourth one. So second is correct, third is correct, fourth also correct. So in which option 2, 3, 4 correct given? The option C you check. 2, 3, 4 are correct. So correct answer is C. Presence of halogen in organic compound is detected by Lazenz test. So children, you should go through the synopsis which are given in any organic book or NCERT book. So for the basic principles and techniques, you must go through them. That is just memory based. Nitrogen, halogens, sulfur are detected by Lazenz test by heating with sodium metal. So answer is A. Presence of halogens in organic compound is detected by, the metal used in the Lazenz test is nothing but sodium. The given organic compound is heated with sodium, then ionic compound is obtained. That ionic compound is present in fusion extract. That fusion extract is used for the testing of nitrogen, sulfur or halogens. So answer is B. Lazenz test of thiourea is converted to, during the Lazenz test, given organic compound is fused with sodium metal. Thiourea, we should know what is the urea, CO, both the sides NH2 groups. This is urea. In this urea, 3 types of elements are present: carbon, nitrogen, oxygen. In thiourea, oxygen is replaced with sulfur. That is thiourea. So this compound, when it is heated with sodium metal, it combines with carbon, nitrogen and sulfur. So the compound formed is nothing but NaSCN, sodium thiocyanate, Na plus SCN minus, sodium thiocyanate. This is the correct answer. The purpose of sodium metal in Lassen's test: to convert the elements which are attached to the carbon through covalent bond into water-soluble ionic compounds. If you take halogen, suppose when halogen is attached to carbon in the given organic compound, this is covalent compound. When it is heated with sodium metal, it takes halogen as X minus. So we can get Na plus X minus in the fusion extract. So this is ionic compound. Since it is ionic compound, it is water soluble. So the purpose, water insoluble covalent compound, organic compound, must be converted into water soluble ionic compound. For that purpose, the given organic compound is heated with sodium. So answer is C. The percentage of carbon in acetic acid. So we should know what is acetic acid. CH3COOH, C2H4O2. First you calculate the molecular weight in grams. Carbon 12 grams, other carbon 12 grams. Hydrogens, 4 hydrogens are there. So 4 into 1, 4. Oxygens, 16 and 16. So total 60. If you want, you can express it in grams. 60 grams of acetic acid contains 2 atoms of carbon, means 24 grams of carbon. Percent, they are asking. Percent means per 100 how many grams. 60 grams contain 24 grams of carbon. 100 grams contain how much? So cross multiplication, 24 into 100 divided by 60. I think it gives 40. 40% of carbon is present. So general formula to calculate the percentage of any atom: total amount of the atom which is asking, 2 carbons are there, 24, by gram molecular weight of the entire molecule into 100. This is a general formula to calculate percentage. So answer is 40. A compound with empirical formula CH2O has a vapor density 30. Its molecular formula is. Now, when empirical formula and molecular weight is known, we can calculate the molecular formula. Molecular formula is equal to an integer into empirical formula. That integer is calculated by the formula molecular weight in grams by empirical formula weight in grams. Molecular weight, suppose not given, molecular weight is nothing but 2 into vapor density. So 2 into vapor density divided by empirical formula weight, then we can get N. So in this case, CH2O, the molecular empirical formula weight 12, 1, 1 and 16, that is nothing but 30. Vapor density is given 30. So molecular weight is equal to 2 into vapor density, 2 into 30, total 60. So now integer N is obtained by the molecular weight 60 divided by empirical formula weight 30. So integer is 2. That's why molecular formula is equal to 2 into CH2O, that is nothing but C2H4O2. So answer is B. Next, again IUPAC name. First, you select the longest carbon chain including double bond. This is the longest carbon chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Carbon with double bond should get the smallest possible number. Then you select the substituents. There are two substituents. One is at second position, other one is at fourth position. That's why 2, 4 dimethyl pent, no space between those two, pent, one ene. So you check the options, 2, 4 dimethyl, there is no space here, pent, one ene, option A. Next, again IUPAC name. Here the functional group is CN, C triple bond N. This is chain terminating functional group. Carbon of the CN gets number 1. When CN is there, the carbon of CN also included in the main carbon chain. That's why when we are taking secondary suffix, it is named as nitrile. So 1, 2, 3. Prop 2 in nitrile. Otherwise, 2 propene. Since double bond is at second carbon, 2-propene-nitrile. This is the correct option. Diastereomers or optical isomers are two types. Non-superimposable and mirror images are called enantiomers. Non-superimposable and non-mirror images are called diastereomers. That's why you select the correct option, stereomers that are non-superimposable, non-mirror images. Stereoisomers that are non-superimposable and non-mirror images are called diastereomers. First option only correct. Next option B, you observe isomers that only differ in the bonding arrangement of atoms, that they are structural isomers. Stereoisomers that are non-superimposable mirror images. Third option also wrong because they are enantiomers. Isomers that only differ by rotations around the single bond, they are conformational isomers. That's why D option is wrong. So correct option is A. The specific rotation of an optically active compound is 160. Whenever it is 100% pure, the specific rotation is 160 degrees. No other impurity. The observed specific rotation of a mixture containing 25% levo and 75% dextro. So in this mixture, dextro is dominating levo. So 25% levo is cancelled by, neutralized by 25% dextro. That's why 50% racemic mixture we can get. 50% racemic mixture. The remaining 50% enantiomeric excess. So here enantiomeric excess is 50%. That is nothing but dextro only. So since it is 50% pure, dextro, if it is 100% pure, 160 degrees. Now dextro is how much pure? 50% only. That's why the specific rotation for 50% extra enantiomer is nothing but half of that, 80 degrees plus 80 degrees. Since the extra one is dextro plus a symbol. This is the correct answer. Which of the following shows optical isomerism? To exhibit optical isomerism, minimum condition, lack of symmetry. No symmetry is the essential element to make it optically active. So, when the structure is given on the paper, how to recognize whether it is rotating plane or polarized light or not? it should have chiral carbon. So which of the following shows optical isomerism? Means it should have at least one chiral carbon. Carbon which is attached to four different groups is called chiral carbon. So let us take first option, lactic acid, CH3CHOHCOH. So you should know the structure of lactic acid, then only you can find out whether it is exhibiting optical isomerism or not. So one chiral carbon is there, second carbon is chiral carbon. So lactic acid exhibits optical isomerism. Next, 1-chloro-1-bromo-ethane, CH3-CClBr. At the same carbon, both are there. So first carbon itself chiral carbon, since it is attached to four different. So 1-chloro-1-bromo-ethane also exhibits. Next, 2-bromo-3-methyl-heptane only. Heptane, 7 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. At third position, okay, you can take 3-bromo also, no problem. 3-bromo-3-methyl-heptane. So this is chiral carbon. That's why C also correct. So since these three are optically active, exhibit optical isomerism, the correct option goes to D. You have to take care about this type of questions. So don't take the final answer as A or B as you are getting correct answer. You have to check four options. D is the correct answer. Optically active isomers but not mirror images. Just now we discussed they are nothing but diastereomers. So answer is D. If they are exactly mirror images, called enantiomers. If they are not mirror images, diastereomers. How many optical isomers are possible for lactic acid? So just now we discussed CH3COH HCOH. This is the chiral carbon. Let it be dextrorotatory. Just by exchanging two groups at chiral carbon, we can get another one, HOHCOH. Now these two are exactly mirror images. Of course, by seeing these structures, you can't understand. So if one is dextrorotatory, definitely other one is levorotatory. Since only one chiral carbon is there, there are two optical isomers. Otherwise, one formula is there to get the number of optical isomers, 2 power n. Total number of optical isomers is equal to 2 power n. N indicates number of chiral carbons, but condition is there, plane of symmetry should not be there. If plane of symmetry is not there, total number of optical isomers formula, 2 power n, where n is the chiral carbon. So here answer is A. Mesotartaric acid and dextrotartaric acid. So tartaric acid formula, COOH, CHOH, CHOH, COOH. 2,3-dihydroxy, butane, 1,4-dioic acid is tartaric acid. So let us draw its Fischer projection formula. OH, OH right side, COOH, COOH. This is Fischer projection formula to indicate tartaric acid. But if second carbon and third carbon both are chiral, but the overall molecule is optically inactive. The reason, there is a plane of symmetry between 2 and 3 carbons. Because of this plane of symmetry, upper part and below part both will become mirror images of each other. The optical rotation made by upper part is cancelled by below part. So overall molecule becomes optically inactive. such type of optically inactive compound, even though chiral carbons are there, is called mesotartaric acid. So this is mesotartaric acid. Dextrotartaric acid, you exchange two groups at any one chiral carbon. Just by writing the structure exactly, you can't tell which is dextro, which is levo. Just for understanding purpose, I am giving this one as dextrotartaric acid. The first one is mesotartaric. Mesotartaric acid is optically inactive. Dextrotartaric acid is optically active. Now the relation between these two. These two are non-superimposable, but not exactly mirror images. So these are non-superimposable, but not mirror images of each other. That type of mixture is the type of two compounds called diastereomers. So the answer is C, diastereomers. Which of the following compounds possess the CH bond with the lowest bond dissociation energy? So bond dissociation energy depends on the stability of free radical formed. Let us take propane, CH3, CH2, CH3. When bond is broken at first carbon, CH bond, we can get 1 degree free radical. If CH bond is broken at middle carbon, we can get 2 degree free radical. So this is rate determining step. In this rate determining step, which free radical is stable, that compound will be formed quickly by using lesser bond dissociation energy. So we know 2 degree free radical is more stable. Since 2 degree free radical is stable, the CH bond of the middle carbon can be broken easily. So the bond dissociation energy is inversely proportional to the stability of free radical formed after the removal of hydrogen dot, hydrogen free radical. So from first carbon or from second carbon, from which one we can remove hydrogen easily by using less amount of energy? That is from second carbon, because it is going to form 2 degree free radical. Similarly, from these four options, we have to check which one can give free radical, stable free radical. Option A, you select toluene. Methyl benzene is toluene. You remove hydrogen from CH3 of the toluene. H dot removed from CH3 carbon. Then we can get benzyl free radical. That benzyl free radical is stable since unpaired electron is in conjugation with pi bond of the benzene ring. This is benzyl free radical. Since benzyl free radical is the highest stable among these, the breaking of CH bond from CH3 can take less amount of dissociation energy. So the answer is toluene. Isomers which can be converted into one another by free rotation around CC single bond. By the free rotation around CC single bond, we can get conformational isomers. They are also called rotamers. They are also called conformations. That's why answer is A. Ethanol and methoxymethane are dash type of isomers. Let us write the structures. Ethanol, CH3, CH2OH. This is ethanol. Methoxymethane, CH3. Methane, to this methoxy is attached. This is methoxymethane. For both of them, molecular formula remains same. C2H6O, C2H6O. That's why both are isomers. What type of isomers? What is the difference? So the type of isomers depends on the difference between those two, which are having same formula. So in this case, ethyl alcohol has functional group alcoholic group, and in the second one, methoxymethane, the functional group is ether. That's why, since both are differ only in the case of functional group, they are called functional group isomers or functional isomers. So the correct answer is B. Which one of the following series contains electrophiles only? Electrophile means species which is which has affinity towards electrons. Electron seeking species is electrophile. Cations and electron deficient molecules can act as electrophiles. First option, H2O, since it has lone pair at oxygen, it cannot act as electrophile, moreover it acts as nucleophile. That's why, so among, in each option, three species given, three out of three must be electrophiles. So since H2O is nucleophile, A is wrong option. Here also H2O is present, B is wrong answer. In option D also H2O is present, D is wrong. You check the option C, no need to check, actually this is correct answer. AlCl3, it is electron deficient, 6 electrons only around aluminum, so it acts as electrophile. SO3 also electrophile, it can extend its octet, and NO2 plus automatically electrophile due to positive charge and empty orbital. So option is, correct option is C. Which of the following formed by heterolytic cleavage? When a bond is undergoing heterolytic cleavage, suppose CO bond, the bond pair, CO bond pair completely shifted onto O since it is more electronegative. Carbon, since it is losing its electron, becomes cation. O is getting one extra electron anion. So this type of cleavage of the bond is called heterolytic cleavage, bond fission, heterolysis. During the heterolysis, cations as well as anions both are obtained. So the correct option is both cation and anion are obtained. The correct answer is C. Which of the following order is not correct regarding minus I effect? All halogens are acting as minus I groups since they are higher electronegative. Regarding halogens, since fluorine is highest electronegative, fluorine minus I order, order of halogens with respect to their negative inductive effect. After fluorine, chlorine, next bromine, next iodine. But you check the option A here. After fluorine, given one is bromine. After bromine, chlorine is given. So this is wrong. They are asking not correct. You have to take care regard this type of questions. Not correct. So this is wrong answer. The remaining three are correct options only with respect to their minus I effect. So here correct answer is A. Which of the following species is paramagnetic? Paramagnetic is one which contains one unpaired electron, odd electron. So free radical has one unpaired electron. If you take this free radical, CH3 free radical, around the carbon, in each bond, two electrons, you know, 2 × 3, total 6 electrons, plus one unpaired electron. So total number of electrons, 7 only. Since one unpaired electron is there in the free radical, this is paramagnetic in nature. So which of the following species is paramagnetic? Answer is B. In carbonium ion, unpaired electron is not present. Let it be CH3 plus carbonium ion. There are 6 electrons, odd number of electrons not there. This is diamagnetic. Carbene ion, C minus. Suppose if you take methyl carbene ion, 2, 2, 2, 6. Negative charge is there, that is also equivalent to 2 electrons. Total 8 electrons. So this is also diamagnetic. Correct answer here, B. Hyperconjugation effect is also called. During hyperconjugation, conjugation between alpha CH sigma bond pair and sp2 carbon. Positively charged carbon is sp2 carbon or doubly bonded carbon or free radical. So between positive charge of the sp2 carbon and sigma bond pair of the alpha CH bond, conjugation is there. When CH sigma bond pair is dropped between two carbons, we can get a resonance structure. Hydrogen still staying there only with positive charge. So these two are resonance structures. In the second one, there is no bond between carbon and H plus. This type of resonance structure is called no bond resonance structure. So hyperconjugation effect is also called no bond resonance. Answer is A. Choose the correct statement from each of the following sets. Secondary carbonium ion or carbocation is more stable than tertiary. That is wrong. So regarding carbocations, stability order: methyl carbocation, next 1 degree carbocation, next 2 degree carbocation, next 3 degree carbocation, then allyl carbocation, then benzyl carbocation. So you know the stability order. So secondary carbocation is more stable than tertiary. That is wrong statement. They are asking correct statement only. Next, tertiary carbonium ion is more stable than primary as well as secondary. This is correct option. Next, you check other two also. Tertiary carbonium ion, can the charge bearing carbon with positive charge is undergoing sp3. That is wrong. The carbon with positive charge undergoes sp2 hybridization. So C option is wrong. In tertiary carbonium ion, the charge bearing carbon is sp hybrid. That is also wrong. So correct answer in this case B. Which of the following has zero dipole moment? So let us take trans-butene. In trans-2-butene, this is trans-2-butene. You check the net dipole moment should be zero. Resulting dipole moment should be zero. Between CH3 and doubly bonded carbon, bond moment towards doubly bonded carbon since it is more electronegative. Here, so these two bond moments exactly cancelled. Similarly, CH bond moment, these two also exactly cancelled. That's why for trans 2 butene, net dipole moment is zero. For cis 2 butene, bond moment is not zero, because bond moments are not cancelled properly. So this bond moment and this bond moment both are not equal in the magnitude. That's why exact cancellation is not possible. Net dipole moment is greater than zero for cis 2-butene. If you take metachlorotoluene. So here bond moment towards chlorine, here bond moment towards benzene. There is no exact cancellation of bond moments. That's why it is polar molecule. Net dipole moment is not zero. 2-methylpropionine. This is 2-methylpropionine. This is a structure. So in this case, bond moments are not exactly cancelled. That's why this is also polar molecule. So correct answer in this case, B. Which of the following compounds are enantiomers? Already I told, non-superimposable, but mirror images called enantiomers. Let us check the option A. These two are non-superimposable, exactly mirror images of each other. You observe OH right side, OH left side, H right side, H left side. These are exactly mirror images. So, enantiomers. So, correct option is A. Remaining you can check. B option, OH, H right side here, OH, OH left side. These two are non-superimposable, but not mirror images. B, option B indicates diastereomers. Option C indicates diastereomers. Option D also indicates diastereomers. So, the correct answer is A. If a compound has N dissymmetric carbon atoms, dissymmetric means chiral carbons. If the number of chiral carbons N, already I told, total number of optical isomers 2 power N, when there is no plane of symmetry. So, the correct option is B, the possible number of optical isomers 2 power N. Correct answer is B. Ethanol is converted into methanol by the following sequence. For each step, you write the equation. Ethyl alcohol first oxidized to carboxylic acid by strong oxidizing agent. Strong oxidizing agent is needed. Acetic acid by using A converted into sodium acetate. So, to convert sodium acetate, two reagents we can use. One is sodium, other one is sodium hydroxide. Any one reagent is suitable. So, A may be sodium or sodium hydroxide. Next, sodium acetate is converted into methane by decarboxylation. Decarboxylation can be done by soda lime. So, soda lime is used here. Soda lime is nothing but sodium hydroxide plus NaO, CaO. This mixture is used to remove CO2 to produce methane. So, in the option B, B should be soda lime. So, with these two, you can find out the correct answer, I think. Methane is converted into CH3Cl. Then chlorine is required in the presence of sunlight. So, C must be chlorine. So, now you select the correct option. They are asking only A, B, C. A may be sodium, next B soda lime, C. So, A is correct answer. Since D option is both A and B, you have to check B also. First, A is sodium hydroxide, correct only. Soda lime, chlorine. So, B option also correct. Next, option C, sodium hydroxide, soda lime and PCl3. From CH4, you can't get CH3Cl by reacting with PCl3. That's why C option is wrong. So, now both A and B both are correct. That's why option is correct option here, D. Tautomerism is not exhibited by. To exhibit tautomerism, minimum condition alpha hydrogen on sp3 carbon, you remember, and electron withdrawing group like CO, NO. In the first case, A option, this is alpha hydrogen. The alpha hydrogen attached to sp2 carbon. In the opposite side also, alpha hydrogen is present, but that is attached to sp2 carbon. So, alpha hydrogen should be present to exhibit tautomerism, but that alpha carbon should be sp3 carbon. You remember, alpha carbon should not have pi bond. So, in this case also, this is sp2 carbon, alpha carbon. This is also sp2 carbon. That's why A cannot exhibit tautomerism. If you take option B, okay, why A also not exhibiting? If H is shifted, if alpha hydrogen is shifted from alpha carbon to oxygen, you can get OH, double bond, consecutive CC double bonds in the ring is to be formed. So this type of molecule is impossible. Two consecutive double bonds are not present inside of the ring due to highest angle strain. So H will not be migrated to oxygen. It will try to stay only at alpha carbon. If you take B, H is migrated to carbon and pi bond is shifted. This will exhibit, this will exhibit, even this also will exhibit. So correct answer is A. Okay, so like this you have to solve the problems. In CET simple questions only they will give, but some logic you should have, memory as well as application knowledge. I hope you have to practice. I hope you are able to practice as many questions as possible before going to attempt CET. Okay students, with this I want to conclude.